Good day, liberators and fellow South Africans. It appears as if there's a notion again being pushed for some pandemic of a disease coming our way. And I've just seen during the course of this week, I've seen a notice going around in Pretoria that they are worried that shingles, it's actually called shingles, but monkeypox have broken out, and they're afraid that we might be affected by monkeypox as well. But and I come back to the point whereby, why did I say shingles? Shingles is the other word for monkeypox, the other name of the disease. And strangely enough, that shingles is also a new effect of one of these, specifically one of these vaccines that have been approved and that finally registered in South Africa, and which is part of our case against the South African Health Products Regulatory Authority. Now, we have launched this application in June 2022 already, so it's 2 years ago already. It should have been a urgent application to review the registration of several of all the COVID-19 vaccines. Why did we not launch it on an urgent basis is because we knew that the courts would kick us out on urgency. They would find a way to just kick us out. And so we've lodged it on a normal basis, and SAHPRA, the South African Health Products Regulatory Authority, has stalled this process for 2 years. And why we were supposed, or the reason why we were in court on Thursday, the 13th of June, 2024, in the High Court in Pretoria, was specifically to compel SAHPRA to produce the full unredacted record of the vaccines, of those vaccines. They produced us more than 500 pages of records of five registered COVID-19 vaccines before, but almost half, if not more than half, were redacted in black. So based on SAHPRA's belief that they were private and confidential information. And unfortunately, we've tried to get the full record, and then they said that they made the excuse that the case is only against SAHPRA. We should have joined or cited the five manufacturers as well. And our position was always that the decision was with SAHPRA. So the decision that's being reviewed is the decision of SAHPRA for each one of those matters. We have, not only us, but SAHPRA have also informed these manufacturers. They were well aware of the processes being followed, and our position was always that we notify you of all the processes, and it's up to you as the manufacturer to come to court if you want to intervene. But we're not going to send an invitation on a red carpet to say that you are part of these processes from the very beginning. It's you who decide whether your interests are going to be violated by this process, yes or no. But what has subsequently happened was that SAHPRA, instead of protecting the rights of the 60 million people in South Africa, they have gone out with aggression to protect the rights of these five manufacturers. They have come to court on Thursday to aggressively argue the case of the five manufacturers whose rights are being violated because they are not before court. But our argument was always that it's not our responsibility to invite any interested party. There could be 60 million interested parties who's directly affected by this. But how long must we send an invitation and notify these manufacturers that this court case is going on and your rights might be violated? We're not sure, but it's your decision to be part of this. And there was aggressive, really aggressive arguments from SAHPRA side to protect the rights of the manufacturers, and they felt absolutely nothing for the 60 million people in South Africa. That's your government that you have, and I'm talking to the DA voters specifically, that's your government that you have elected now into government who's doing that. So now the problem is that, okay, but I'll get to the problem, but I need to tell you what happened and why I'm actually very happy about the court case and what transpired on Thursday. The case started at 10 o'clock. We only knew about another case that was, unfortunately, there was a problem of a fault on the court roll, and another matter was not properly cited. We thought that our case was written in twice, but there was a different court case number for the one incorrect enrollment of our case. And then it was for another case. And so they were actually, we've decided that they must argue the case before us as the last case for the day before Justice Lenyai. And but while I was sitting, we were supposed to introduce ourselves to the judge quarter to 10 that morning. So there's just this practice in court that practitioners or parties go to a judge and just introduce themselves, who they are, and say that they are there. But in any case, while I was sitting there, the personal assistant of the judge asked me, "Are you the Mr. De Beer?" So I said, "Why do I have a reputation?" And she said that no, are you the Mr. De Beer who argued the case before Justice Malindi in that equality court? I said, "Oh no, it's one of our cases." And she said, "Oh, it's good to see a face to the person." And but it came out, and it's not the first time that this has happened at the court. Previously, we also went to the PA of the judge president, Lidwaba. She was very happy actually to see me. So you could see that the court does not only consist out of the judges. There are also people working in the court system as well who are normal citizens, like you and me, who are happy to know that there's someone like Liberty Fighters Network fighting for their rights. And remember that these PAs and stenographers are sitting in those court cases daily. They hear the arguments being presented to the judges. They become legal experts themselves by just listening to the cases and also having the papers before them. So they are actually very, very well-read individuals. Although they are possibly, most of them, not legal practitioners themselves, they also learn about the law just like I had to learn over the past 30 years. And for them to come out on various occasions to be happy to see me, knowing and acknowledging the good work that we are doing for the people on the grassroots level, and they also don't like the legal practitioners. They also not fans of the legal fraternity, and for them to come out and support you is really, or give you that extra confidence that, okay, you are doing something right. But when our case started at 12:15, I was the only one in the courtroom for Liberty Fighters Network and myself, the applicants. There were no supporters. My colleagues, most of them are not even in Gauteng, so I acknowledge that they couldn't be there. Herman and others were busy with very important matters. So I was the only one standing there. But I had two advocates and five attorneys for SAHPRA, aggressively defending the case for the manufacturers of those vaccines. But a very important thing, that I've presented my arguments, but the judge, Justice Lenyai, was very calm, and you could see that she appreciated my arguments as a layperson. And so irrespective of what is going to be her judgment, I believe she positively interacted, and she, if she can find in our favor, she will definitely do that. But she will definitely be very, very reasonable in her findings, even if it goes against us. But I don't anticipate that there will be a finding against us specifically. The purpose of that hearing was to order, compel SAHPRA to produce the full unredacted record. As I've indicated before, that when they produce the record, they've redacted more than half of the pages. So we couldn't, it blacked out because of privilege and privacy of the manufacturers. So we had to go to court now, and this case has been stalling now already for 2 years by SAHPRA, They're not coming forward to the party to say that we are transparent, here are the records, go and let's finalize this case. No, by protecting the rights of the manufacturers. So it's not the institution SAHPRA as such that is protecting, it's the decision makers of SAHPRA who don't want the evidence to come out. So as I'm saying, that there's so many irregularities in the approval process, the final registration approval process surrounding these vaccines. And we do know that another contract did come out some time ago where the supply agreement, and it was scary to say the least. And we just want the medication, what is going to be put and what have been put into our people, mainly forced vaccinations. We just want to know how it was approved. How did it come? Is it safe? Is it really safe? What are the components? Because according to their own website, all these vaccines does not have any component. It says none. So we always had the opinion that that is it possible that the reason why these vaccines have been pushed and everyone have been coerced that you must get this, is it maybe that they knew that there were most possibly only saline solution in there, saline salt solution, meaning that there's no new effects or anything that can disturb your body or be negative towards you. But in the same sense, we do know that there has been reports and a lot of them that apparently these vaccines have created new effects and killed people allegedly, and also caused a lot of damages, health hazards to people who receive these. So without the actual record of the medication, the vaccines itself, there will always be a dark spot over COVID-19 in general, because there will always be suspicion. Because they're not coming forward, they are not transparent. And for SAHPRA to use your taxpayer money to have an extensive legal team, five attorneys and two advocates fighting against the layperson, and their best argument was Mr. Reyno De Beer may not represent Liberty Fighters Network because he's not a legal practitioner. An argument I've had plenty of time before, so I know how to move myself around that. But the fact of the matter is that okay, the case has been heard. So we are just waiting for the court's finding. There is the possibility that the court will say that no, we must first go and join the other five parties, and then we'll do it. We're not going to stop with this process. We're going to continue with this until the very end. So if it comes back to say that we have to join those parties, manufacturers, we'll do that. But the fact of the matter is that SAHPRA was supposed to come out in defense of the people and not five manufacturers. So the fact that they are protecting the five manufacturers implies that the individuals, the officers of SAHPRA, wants to protect them. And they don't think one bit of what those vaccines have caused or are causing to the people at all. Frightening, to say the least. So people, that is the report back on the South African Health Products Regulatory Authority's case. Please support us. We only function on voluntary donations. We don't have a funder out there, irrespective of whatever our enemies are constantly saying on social media and push a negative agenda against us. So at the end of the day, this is my full-time job, together with others as well, and we also need to survive. Without your voluntary donations to us, we cannot pursue this for all the people. There's no benefit that besides the fact that we are fighting for our liberties together. There's no financial benefit at the end of the day for pursuing this for you and for us. And so we are here as a team, to work in a team. So please support us where you can. And thank you very much for your support. We really appreciate it. We will be back with other valuable information. And please share this as far as wide as you can, because we have been blacked out in the media. Social media sites also do not send out our posts as regularly and as many as possible as well. There has been restrictions. And also, unfortunately, other organizations are there for themselves, benefiting themselves, and they don't want you to know this valuable information, which is obviously in public interest. Until the next time, Godspeed.
Liberty Fighters Network.
Liberty Fighters Network.
Liberty Fighters Network.